Dear students, already I have completed patterns of sentences in the previous video, and I have also given you exercises to do. I have taught you all today. I will teach you types of sentences. Before that, you remember that this word sentence comes from the Latin, that is to fill. Sentences. If I say, I am a teacher, it is simply a statement, what you call as declarative. If I tell, go there, it is imperative. If I tell, are you happy, this is interrogative. And if I say, that's how tall you are, it is exclamatory. So, there are four types of sentences as you find in your grammar book. And you have been given some exercises to do. I will simply clarify the exercises. Before that, I will teach you what is declarative, what is imperative, what is interrogative, and what is exclamatory. Now, let's learn types of sentences. So, first you remember what is sentences. Then I'll come to types of sentences. You write down the ability to speak right by constructing the complex objects which are sentences is something that only humans can do. Other animals communicate, but sentence structure is beyond them. There is no sentence structure that is to be obeyed by the animals. Only humans are constrained with some rules, constrained with some sentence structure. So, types of sentences, you write them down, very important thing, the ability to speak or write by constructing the complex objects which are sentences is something that only humans can do. Other animals communicate, but sentence structure is beyond them. It has been said by Nigel Farb in sentence structure. Now come to types of sentences. Declarative, your declarative sentence is otherwise known as only statements. I am happy. Imperative, go there, open the door, sit down, please open the door, kindly sit down. Then interrogative, are you happy? Do you speak English? Can you speak English? Question mark is there. Your exclamatory, how tall you are? So in short, declarative, imperative, interrogative, exclamatory, D-I-I-E. You just write them down. So one by one, I will explain to you all these things. Then we shall go to exercises. I will simplify them. It will help you secure good marks. So you just write them now, first of all. Well, I have already told you that there are four types of sentences. That is declarative, imperative, interrogative, and exclamatory. Now I will teach you that one. Declarative sentence begins with subject, capital letter, ends with full stop, interrogative, ends with interrogative mark or question mark, imperative, ends with full stop, exclamatory, ends with exclamatory mark. Examples, I am happy, I is the subject. So in declarative sentence, subject must be there. I am happy ends with full stop. I am happy, you are a teacher, he is going, she is happy. Remember, please sit down, your subject you is hidden, and ends with also full stop. This is imperative sentence. And your imperative sentence also begins with main verb, go there, open the door, begins with kindly go there. So please go there, kindly go there, open the door, even do not go there, do not play ball. This is your imperative sentence. Are you sure? Very simple to remember. Interrogative, question mark is there, that is interrogative. What an idea ends with exclamatory mark. This is also very simple. You just write them down, so it will help you remember a lot of things. Now write them down. After that we shall start the exercise. Okay. I will teach a very interesting item of grammar, that is called whip imperative. As you see, that is called whip imperative, WH imperative, or interrogative directive, three names. This whip imperative or WH imperative or interrogative directive was created by the linguist Jerome Shaddock. For example, instead of saying go there, you can say would you go there? The question mark is here, could you help the boy? Question mark is here. This is called your whip imperative. Now I will teach. Just you write them down so that what will happen, that you will know another term for your own academic pleasure, that is whip imperative. You just write them down, then I'm teaching from your grammar book. Come to activity 2. Activity 2, page 16 and 17. The first one is given, where were you absent from class yesterday? Your question mark is there. Why were you absent from class yesterday? Your question mark is there. Simply question mark is there. You can write in example, it is also given interrogative. So this is example. So remember, after absence, we always use the preposition from. Most of the students write he was absent in the class. No, he's absent from class. The second one, let us move on. So remember, if a sentence begins with a let, that is imperative sentence. Let me go begins with a let, imperative sentence. Who told you that story? Question mark, interrogative sentence. How luckily I escaped the accident? Exclamatory mark, exclamatory sentence. Don't touch a live wire. I have already told you, if a sentence begins with don't, even if don't. Please, begins with please. Begins with kindly. Begins with let. Begins with main verb. These are all imperative sentence. Are you coming with him? Exclamatory mark is there. So this is also interrogative. Turn to page 25. It begins with main verb. So this is imperative sentence. So last one, question mark, interrogative sentence. So you just do this and send to me. Then exercise 3. I will complete it on the following declarative sentences into exclamatory sentences using how or what. The first one, I am telling you, the weather is very fine. The weather is very fine. Ending with full stop, begins with the subject. So when you are asked to turn this declarative sentence, this is a declarative sentence into exclamatory sentence, simply write down how and sit down. So after writing how, you find the adjective, you go to the last one. Directly go to the last one. The weather is very fine. The weather is very fantastic. The weather is very cloudy. Whatever it may be. So go to the last one and bring it near fine. Again, the weather is, write down three words. The weather is, or the subject plus verb. How fine the weather is, put this mark. Suppose how fine the weather is, turn to declaration. This is the answer. She's a very intelligent girl. She is a very intelligent girl. Simply, how? Find out the adjective. Suppose girl is not here. After very, here after very fine, after very intelligent, bring that intelligent here. How intelligent a girl she is. Put this mark.
So the third one, he speaks very quickly, how fluently. Last one, fluently, how fluently he speaks. She has got a very sharp memory. What a sharp memory she has got, or how sharp a memory she has got. It is a very beautiful sight. Similarly, what a beautiful night it is. She has put on a very costly necklace. What a costly necklace she has put on. So remember, two exercises I completed. So you just you see these two exercises, page 17. I have given you examples. I have also told you answers on the board, and also verbally I have told you something else. You do this and send to me. Then tomorrow I will teach you your fourth activity. I am telling you fourth activities. It is already written. The examination is at hand. I will teach you. Make the best use of time. Concentrate on your studies. Stop watching television. Take the advice of a teacher when you are in difficulty. Don't get nervous. Always hope for the best. So I will teach you how to do it. It is the work of our brain. So also activity 5, I am telling you, joining with AndBot, etc. Otherwise, this I will teach you tomorrow. And activity 4, 5, 6, I will complete it tomorrow. So after doing this, I will all tell you to remember there are two types of conjunctions, that is coordinating conjunctions or coordinators, then subordinate conjunctions or subordinators. So simply remember what are the subordinate conjunctions are and what so or other research, so that I will teach you and give you with examples so that you can do the exercise. So you do one thing, you complete your exercise activity 2 and 3. And try to do it 4, so that it will be best for you to complete the activities in a very fair manner. So I hope mu madhya tike odia re koi douchi mu activity 2 ebang 3 ko complete koreili bakya ro mul re subject ebang sesare full stop thale taku declarative sentence kanti bakya sesare question mark thale सेटा को इंटरोगेटिव कहती क्वेश्चन मार्क एक्सक्लामेटरी मार्क था एक्सक्लामेटरी सेंटेंस कहती वाक्य मूल प्लीज काइंडली लेट डू नॉट मैन भर थे चार प्रकार जिन प्लीज गो देयर काइंडली गो देयर डू नॉट गो देयर लेट अस गो देयर इट ताको इंपरेटिव सेंटेंस कहती एक्सरसाइज 2 एक्सरसाइज 3 एक्सरसाइज मुझे बुझे वेदर इज फाइन सिंपली हाउ लिखि दियो शेष भेरी पर जहाँ अच्छी हाउ पाक आण मूल नहीं जोड़ी दियो सेटा एक्सक्लामेटरी होगा एवं जदि एक्सलामेटरी को पुणी डेक्लेरेट करिया को तार आंसरटा मध्य उपरे थाए तेणु मु आशा करूछि ताको भलो वर्ड देखे मोर एक्चुअली इंटेंशन उद्देश्य होछि तुम मानको परीक्षा रे भलो करे करेबार प्रयास मु करिछि मु मध्य एथिपई परिश्रम करूछि इन केस ऑफ एनी डाउट जदि परे आंसर करिया परे मध्य मते बदलि परिबो यू शेयर इट एंड सब्सक्राइब इट थैंक यू वेरी मच थैंक यू